Good morning, and welcome to the Space Station Live from the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas. We're here in the Space Station Flight Control Room, where the team is monitoring the International Space Station, all systems performing well, and on board, their crew activities likewise going smoothly. The team is being led by Flight Director Greg Whitney today, who's overseeing the team and the operations this morning. The Flight Director is closely supported by the CAPCON, shown here in red, and serving in that role today is astronaut Serena Annan. While the on-orbit activities are going smoothly on the ground, the countdown is continuing for today's scheduled launch of the European Space Agency's Albert Einstein Automated Transfer Vehicle cargo ship. Perched atop a 168-foot-high Ariane 5 rocket on a launch pad in Kourou, French Guiana, the Albert Einstein is poised to lift off at 4:52 p.m. Central Time, 6:52 p.m. Kourou Time, at an instant launch window to deliver 7.3 tons of cargo to the Expedition 36 crew on the space station. The cargo includes more than 5,000 pounds of dry cargo, experiment hardware and supplies, as well as nearly 2,000 pounds of propellant for transfer to the Zvezda service module. It's also carrying more than 5,000 pounds of propellant for reboost and debris avoidance maneuver capability, 1,200 pounds of water, and 220 pounds of oxygen and air. The ATV is scheduled to dock to the aft port of Zvezda on June 15th, 4 days after the departure of the Russian Space Station Progress 51 cargo ship that arrived on April 26th. Our coverage of that launch this afternoon will begin at 4:15 p.m. Central Time on NASA TV. In space, the Expedition 36 crew is at work and already in the afternoon of their crew day. The crew, including its three newest crew members, NASA astronauts Karen Nyberg, Chris Cassidy, and European Space Agency astronaut Luca Parmitano, and Russian cosmonauts Alexander Masurkin, Fyodor Yurchikhin, and Pavel Vinogradov serving as commander. One of the major activities today is the various exams as part of the ocular health study, which will collect data about the health and condition of various crew members' eyesight and vision. Both Karen Nyberg and Luca Parmitano are the test subjects for that study today and have several hours dedicated to the various science runs. They'll be assisted by astronaut Chris Cassidy for some of that work, including the ocular health, fundoscope, and tonometry. We'll have more information on that later this hour. Chris Cassidy's work also included evaluation and monitoring of the viable experiment and exercise sessions. Karen Nyberg's also participating in the Pro-K nutritional experiment, as well as a private medical conference and handover time with Chris Cassidy. Her counterpart, European Space Agency astronaut Luca Parmitano, again joining for some of the ocular health research work, but also has some familiarization time on board the complex. Their Russian counterparts, Pavel Vinogradov, Alexander Masurkin, and Fyodor Yurchikhin, will be working in the Russian segment. They're working on maintenance work of the urine tank and the Rodnik water tanks, as well as fan cleaning of the mini research module and coolant system maintenance. Once the crew members have wrapped up their afternoon activities, they'll have a end-of-day daily planning conference shortly after 2 p.m. Central Time. They have off-duty time for evening meal, personal time, and a few end-of-day tasks and data collections before their scheduled crew sleep at 4:30 p.m. Central Time. As per the routine, the crew woke up at 1 a.m. Central Time, and after their personal time and breakfast, had a morning tag up with the ground control teams. The morning activities included back-to-back exercise sessions for astronaut Chris Cassidy and then work in the Japanese experiment module. Karen Nyberg and Luca Parmitano again doing some of the ocular health study work, including the tonometry runs. Their counterparts again, Pavel Vinogradov, Masurkin, and Yurchikhin. Again, continuing with some Russian experiment work as well as maintenance, including the cleaning of the FGB filters and continued work with the BAR experiment, which studies methods and instruments for detecting the location of an air leak from one of the station's modules. Again, that brings us to the early afternoon of the crew day, all the crew activities as well as the vehicle performing well and the spacecraft just making its way over the southern tip of South Africa.